the first round, I still felt a little off.
Yeah.
But I just had to, I guess, get the fidgety part away. But after that, the second round, so let me be a little more firm and be more composed and got to manage.
Looks like you were setting up that shot.
You know, I was trying to move to see where he was going to bite from. I was trying to throw some fakes. And in the beginning, he didn't bite. But after a while, I was throwing the lead left hand, and I kept landing it. So then I believe that was the opener. So then when I started faking, he started biting, so I could know more or less which way to go.
Did you know the moment that it landed that was going to be the shot that pretty much led to the end of the fight?
My thing was trying to stop him at the body shots, but I saw he was leaning over when I was throwing him, so I'm like, if I catch him with his uppercut, it's over.
Why were you going for the body shots first?
You know, my last fight, I got hit with a body shot, and I'm like, you know what? I've been practicing a lot on body shots. I'm underrated for my body shots, and I feel like I'm a power puncher down there. I'm not a big puncher, but down there, I feel like I am.
What happened after your last fight? I mean, like, was it more mental? Was it physical? That it took time to just, you know, recuperate and get back into it?
Spending time with the family, recuperating, and give it some thought. Do I really want this, or should I just hang it up? But I'm passionate. This is something I want, and that wasn't the way I wanted to go out, and I still got a lot of fighting, and I'm ready to give the world some more action.
If you came close to maybe thinking about that you don't want to fight anymore, maybe that was...
That's probably the whole thing why I took some time off, to see if this is what I wanted. But waking up at 4 in the morning, still in the cold, and being able to get up and go running, I knew I still had it.
It looks like you added a shoulder roll, and then, but except for backing up, you were kind of shoulder rolling going forward and walking them down with it. Did you add that in training camp?
You know, I've been working so much on a lot of things. You know, I got a new coach, Sosa. Got my old assistant coach now. He's my first coach, and you know, made some changes in the team. Still with my conditioner coach, Scooter. My manager goes to Ghana, and we're working, man. It's been 11 months out, but I've been in the gym working.
Did you feel any of the shots?
What are your plans now? How soon do you want to fight again?
I'm going to take a week off, see my grandkids. I haven't seen them in 3 months. And try to get back in the drawing board, hopefully in July. Yeah, I got two grandkids. I'm an old grandpa. Yeah. A young grandpa.
What was your mindset after the Khan loss? Because you went from a high to a low, from Victor Ortiz to Amir Khan.
You know, that fight there, I took a short notice, 3 weeks. And it hurt. You know, after coming out a victorious win, a TKO win, after that, from the Victor Ortiz fight to go to that, it was just a heartbreaker. But you know what? I truly believe life without a challenge is not a life. And I wanted to get some challenge some more.
You want to face some more, you know, top caliber guys? Do you need more time? More tune-up fights?
I'm ready. I'm ready. Whatever my team want to put together, whatever I'm going to put together, I'm willing and able, and I'm ready to go. You know, it's finished second round knockout. And I'm ready. Take a week off and go back to the drum board. Let's go.
What do you feel you got to do to put your name back out there? You still feel that you're up there with the Ortizes and Thurmans. How do you feel that you need to put your name back out there?
Hey, I got to get one of those big top guys.
Is that what you want? How soon do you want it?
Hey, I never ducked no one. That's one thing about me. I always fought whoever it was that they put in front of me. And I'm willing to do that. As long as they give me time to train, I'm willing to go in there.
Do you have a specific name in mind, or...?
All the top guys. No specifics. I don't call no one out. Top guys, they want to fight me, I'm here.
How many kids do you have?
I have two daughters, 12 and 20.
Some people say Josito Lopez would be a good matchup for you.
That's what my team. Hey, I'm open for everything. You know, it's up to my manager and Al Heyman. You ready to go?
So you got a lot of fight left in you. How much longer do you see yourself as a professional boxer?
I'm gonna be 34 another week and a half. Maybe another 2-3 years. Whatever. Hey, when my body says it's over, it's over. Okay. I'm not gonna be one of those that are gonna keep fighting just to fight. I don't want that.
And how's your body feeling right now?
Awesome.
So you're staying at this weight class?
Absolutely. I feel strong here. I'm making it with no problem. As long as I got time to train and get ready for a fight, I'm good.
Do you think the hometown advantage helped out at all?
Not really, because it was a little empty, but whatever, it doesn't matter where you go, man. As long as you just prepare yourself mentally and physically, I'm I'm ready to go.
Very comfortable?
Absolutely.
Luis, I know you're a fan real quick. If based on your former opponent, Amir Khan, if that fight comes to intuition with Chris Algieri, how do you see that going?
It's going to be an interesting fight, you know. Chris actually was helping me for this fight here. And it's an interesting fight. He always comes in shape. He always comes ready. And his mental game is just, you know, he got some new changes in his team. But hey, it is what it is, man. And I wish him the best.
Chris give you any nutrition tips?
Not really, because I got my own nutrition. But he's superb with his stuff.
Yeah. You're 2 rankings, you said?
Correct.
Yeah.
I get to enjoy them.
Kind of different.
Yeah, it is. It's amazing though. Just to be, it's not your kid, but it's your grand. It's just totally different right. Love, you know? And I'm able to go out to the park and have to enjoy them. It's great.
Yeah,
that's
cool. Congratulations.
Thank you.
When you're trying to get those top level fights again, thorough things like this certainly help.
Winning these fights in these fashion helps a little. But it was up to them now too and their team. I believe it's supposed to be a lot of media said I was finished already. So I might be the weakest link in the welterweight division. So I'm here.
Hey, yours. Congrats.
Thank you.